I recently searched YouTube for videos about benign prostatic enlargement. What can I say? A lot of the information I found was outdated, oversimplified, misleading, and even false. The most popular of those videos were uploaded by non-urologists, and this is probably the reason. You will be surprised to know that the correlation between prostate size and urinary symptoms is a weak one. If you want to believe that you can effectively shrink your already enlarged prostate by changing your diet and eat certain supplements, then dream on, because you can't. By the way, my name is Stefan Buntrock, I'm a board-certified urologist and sexologist, and I treat patients with prosthetic issues on a daily basis. If you are new to UroChannel, click the subscribe button in the lower right-hand corner, give the video a thumbs up, and activate the bell to never miss out on new and exciting content about urological and sexological conditions. So, what is benign prostatic enlargement? I think you have to understand that it is not some kind of swelling. Therefore, you can't just take a pill to make the swelling go away. BPE is real growth. The prostate is a gland responsible for producing seminal fluid along with the seminal vesicles. With age, the central part of this gland will start to grow. Why this happens, to whom, when, and to what extent is still not exactly known. Traditionally, hormonal changes in the aging male have been regarded as the main trigger, but some years ago, inflammation was identified as another key component in benign prostatic enlargement. Also, the metabolic syndrome definitely is a risk factor, with its signature features, insulin resistance, the hormonal changes it induces, the pelvic atherosclerosis, and the body being in a chronic inflammatory state. While some men only develop moderate enlargement, the prostate will grow to the size of an orange in others. Chestnut is the original size, by the way. Historically, it was believed that these changes then compress the urethra, which is running through the prostate, and hence inhibit urinary flow. This would then result in the typical symptoms of the lower urinary tract: weak stream, hesitancy, urgency, frequency, residual urine, nocturia. Today, we know that it is not as simple as that. The correlation between prostate size and lower urinary tract symptoms, LUTS, is a weak one. The prostate is only part of a system that includes the bladder, the urethra, the pelvic floor, and also the kidneys. Additionally, conditions completely unrelated to urology may also play a role in the development of LUTS. In my practice, I see men with grossly enlarged prostates who empty their bladder properly and have very little bother, while others with only mild to moderate BPE are stressed out big time. So what I have to do as a urologist is to find out what the real cause of the bother is and to treat what I find instead of going for the prostate right away. In my experience, men with an enlarged middle lobe, which is bulging into the bladder, are indeed likely to suffer from a prostatic problem. This is because the middle lobe is acting like a lid on the bladder outlet. But let's say the prostate is enlarged and this is causing symptoms. Is it possible to shrink it with diet and herbal remedies? Simple answer, no, it isn't. There are dietary patterns which increase the risk for BPE. Typically, we are talking about Western lifestyle, but once the damage is done, it can't be reverted by eating a bunch of supplements. Sorry. The tragic thing is, this video should be watched by teenagers and young men, because they still have the chance to switch to a healthy lifestyle and reduce the risk for prostate problems later on. But teenagers and young men are not interested in this kind of information. If you want to shrink your prostate and you don't want surgery, only 5-alpha reductase inhibitors will be able to do that. You might know them by their names finasteride and dutasteride. They block the conversion from testosterone to dihydrotestosterone. This interferes with normal prostate function, and it will make the prostate shrink as a consequence. However, we are talking about roughly 20 to 30%, not more. So if your prostate is 100 ml, you could end up with 70 ml if you're lucky. It then remains to be seen whether it is enough to solve your problem. What about saw palmetto? Saw palmetto acts in a similar fashion and is effective in alleviating LUTs. However, there is no data in the literature how much it reduces prostate size and if it shrinks the prostate at all. I am skipping the other herbal remedies since they don't have any effect on prostate size. Another thing is cream to enhance the prostate. The commercial made me laugh because it is so absurd. A skin cream that shrinks the prostate and enhances erections? Get out of here. So bottom line is, if you experience LUTs, you will have to make an appointment with a urologist to find out what is causing this. Maybe it's the prostate, but it may as well be a urinary tract infection, a hidden diabetes, bladder cancer, urethral stricture, kidney stones, an overactive pelvic floor, and so on. If you are interested in more videos about the prostate, check out this playlist. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.